This program is sponsored by Aishwarya Niketan, its Silent Speaker Sound,
renowned and experienced faculty members,
discipline and perseverance as key motto,
well-equipped labs, science and computer,
diverse explosive skills,
transportation facilities as per the needs,
peaceful environment,
student-centered teaching,
counseling and guidance,
regular school parents interaction,
classes through multimedia,
tours, project works, field visit, case study, presentations and seminars.
Well-stocked library, Aishwarya Niketan, Dhangari, Kailali. If the plan doesn't work, change the plan, but never the goal. Hello everyone and welcome to our Apical TV YouTube channel. You are watching the program, The Voice of Scholars, with me, Ram, and technically supporting me, Anil and Ashok. This program is sponsored by Aishwarya Niketan and GB Mobile Point, Dhangari. In this program, we discuss with different scholars, with their personal life, in relation to their profession. So today we are proud to have one of the scholars having prominent and dazzling personality, principal of Aishwarya Niketan, the campus chief of Aishwarya Multiple Campus. He is also the central member of Nepal Pradhyapak Sangh, advisor of Samudayak Pariri Kendra, Mr. Dharmadev Bhatta. So let me welcome him in our program. First, welcome to our program and thank you for joining with us.
Thank you, welcome, sir.
How is your life moving on, sir?
Smoothly.
You have been engaged in different sectors, different organizations and institutions. You are the campus chief of Aishwarya Multiple Campus and principal of Aishwarya Niketan. Likewise, you are involved in other professions, other institutions. You are the advisor of Parir Samudayak Kendra Dhangari and you are also the central member of Nepal Pradhyapak Sangh. So how are you managing your time?
Yeah, thank you for your question, sir. First of all, we have to manage the time. To manage the time is very important, creative, right? I always know the value of time. The quotation is that time is money, time once lost is never regained, right? So that I'm always focused the times, right? In the world, in the nation, great people, ordinary people, if they have success due to the time management, right? And due to the time, I am engaged in different institution, governmental institution and non-governmental institution. Not only principal, not only campus, I am also different institution. I am busy. I am involved. I am engaged because of I know the manage of time. If every person to know the manage the time, they are success, right? If you ignore the times, if you don't know to manage the time, then you can't progress. So time is money. Time is money. Time is valuable. To know the times, I'm going to progress only the manage the times.
You have been honored by several institutions and organizations. How do you feel by getting such awards and rewards in your life?
Yeah, sir, I feel proud, sir. I feel honored when I awarded the different institution, and I feel very proud, sir. I have awarded the 7,000 institution. Governmental and social, etc. And then when I award it, I feel very proud, sir, because I think that due to my selflessness work, the society, the institution, different institution, to evaluate the work of person, duty of person, task of person, and then I get the awarded with different medal also, certificate also, due to the help of my colleagues, to my family members, and my students, and those persons who make me the courageous to the field of education. Due to these things, I have awarded the different institution. I feel proud, sir.
Really, sir. But you have been very successful in the sector of academic, isn't it? As well as personally, sir. But especially if you have to give credit of your success, to whom would you like to give credit of your success?
Sir, first of all, to be successful, everybody has to struggle, right? Without a struggle, no one can succeed. No one can be successful, right? Even every great people are success due to their struggle. Due to their struggle. Or even every people struggle to become a great. And due to the struggle, I'm also the success in the field of education.
You have been very successful in case of academic life, as well as personally you have been very successful. But especially if you have to give credit of your success, to whom would you like to give credit?
Yeah. Due to this, first of all, this credit goes to my wife's, my elder brothers, and my colleague and well-wishers. Due to their support, due to their help, I'm the success in the field of education. My well-wishers, my elder brothers, my colleagues, especially my wife, always she helps me to courage, to motivate, to do the work in the different fields. So this credit goes to especially wife and my well-wishers, my colleagues and my friends.
Let's go back to your childhood, sir. How was your childhood, sir? And could you talk about your struggle life in your life, sir? How do you come up to now, up to here, regarding your educational matters? And is your beginning stage of your life, sir?
Childhood. Yeah, in childhood, sir, my childhood is struggle, sir. I struggled in childhood, sir, right? And childhood, I'm also the son of the farmer. My father is farmer, and my family is very poor, and my economic condition is pitiable. My economic condition was pitiable, right? And I'm the farmer, and due to the farm, I was engaged with my father, along with him to cut the grass, to planting crops, and cultivated also, and due to the struggle in my childhood, there is one memory was that at the time I was captain of the Nowjawan football team. And I won the football tournament in this time. Then I was very glad, sir. That's the childhood memories.
Is a moment of unforgettable.
Unforgettable memories is that. Nowjawan. I was the captain team of the football tournament. We won the game. Yeah, that was the great memory for me. And we glad to see. To own the game, sir. That is the main memory of my childhood.
Where is your birthplace, sir, actually?
Yeah, my birthplace, the district name is Dalindhura. The birthplace, Ajemeru Village Municipality, Ward number 2, Gurauli. And I spent more than 4 and 5 years in my birthplace, and later on I migrated in Dhangadi Municipality, Ward number 9.
Where did you start your formal education, and where did you complete?
Yeah, my formal institution institution is Namadurga basic level school in Bashana. I studied only 6 months. I studied 6 months in that school, right? Later on, we migrated in Dhangadi, Guhinyaghat. And to continue my study, my parents admit in Dhangadi Secondary School. I study grade 1 to 8, right? For grade 9 to 10, I went to Panchudaya Secondary School is the government school, right? In the same school, I passed the SLC 2045 BS, right? And then I joined the intermediate bachelor. It means I passed the inter and the bachelor level from Koilali Multiple Campus. Yeah, Dhangadi, sir. After passed the bachelor, due to my economic crisis, I taught in different school under the Dhangadi municipality. I taught different schools because of economic crisis. After few years, I went to Kathmandu for the studying in the master level, right? I passed MA and BEd in economics 2055 BS 2055, right? And then when come back from Kathmandu in Dhangadi, I taught various school, various plus two, and various campus level also, right? Since 2058, I joined the Aishwarya Vidya Niketan as a economics teachers in the higher secondary level, right? Since 2065, I have been appointed as a principal Aishwarya Vidya Niketan, and I have been appointed campus of Aishwarya Multiple Campus in the same date. That is my formal education.
Coincidence.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Let's talk about your teaching career. It's relating with teaching career, sir. Why do you join teaching career? Why do you want to come in teaching career of your working place, sir? The reason behind.
Yeah. When I was child, sir, I was thinking at the time, I want to become a teacher. I want to become a good teacher. Teaching is the one of the great profession, right? So I choose the field of education. I choose the teaching profession. Teaching is the one of the pure profession, right? If you appoint a teacher, if you become a teacher, great people will respect you, because our activities, our education, our thing is to change the society. Suppose in the nation, the scholar, doctor, engineer, pilot, and different skilled manpower, they are produced by the help of the teachers, right? Due to the teachers, they become a good personalities in a different sector, right? And suppose you are teacher, and your society, many people will salute you. They are positive you. He's the teacher. He and she is changed our society. Their job is very, prestigious, right? That's why I selected this profession. In this time, when I appointed teachers, only the teachers, In this time, I chanced too many institutions, NGO, but I did not go there, sir. The other time, I did not go. I got the opportunity in different sectors, sir. But my theme, my aim, to become a good teacher. Due to the teaching profession, I have to change the society. In our society, there is too much problems, right? Suppose some people suffering from the superstition. They don't yet get formal education. They are involved in the bad activities. But due to the field of teaching, due to the profession of teaching, automatically will change them. So I choose this profession, sir.
Today we have with us one of the prominent and dazzling personality, the campus chief of Aishwarya Multiple Campus and principal of Aishwarya Vidyaniketan. This program is sponsored by Aishwarya Vidyaniketan and GB Mobile Point Dhangadi. So this is time for short comment.
For grade 11 and 12, Science, Humanities, Management, Education. New program, Hotel Management.
Topper students. We give importance to responsibility and public hearing.
Aishwarya Vidyaniketan, Secondary School, Dhangadi, Kailali.
Welcome back to our program. After a short commercial break, you are watching the program, The Voice of Scholars, through Epical TV YouTube channel. I am Ram, and technically supporting me, Anil and Ashok. Today, I have invited the most prominent and dazzling personality, the campus chief of Aishwarya Multiple Campus, and principal of Aishwarya Vidyaniketan. So again, let me welcome him in our program. Welcome back to our program. There are many schools and colleges, but they don't have much success in the field of academic. But on the other hand, Aishwarya Vidyaniketan has collected its name and fame in academic sectors. What is the reason and element behind its success, sir?
Yeah, thank you for your question, sir. Aishwarya Vidyaniketan is one of the renowned institutions of Parvash Development Region, means province number 7. Yeah. It is run by the Sarvajani Shaichiguti. It is not profitable, non-profitable institution. Right? It has rewarded 12 times in Nepal government. It has received 1 lakh, a national flag, and shield also. Due to these things, Aishwarya Vidyaniketan height is not only province number 7, but its height is in the national level. Because of under this institution, the well-manpowered, highly qualified teachers, discipline, and standard infrastructures. Due to the infrastructure, due to the different facility to the students and skilled teaching staff, and there is the one of the big ground and different facility which is provided by our institution to students and others. Due to these things, this institution day by day to keep its height in the national level, right? Aishwarya Vidyaniketan has provided different facilities also. It is one of the English, one of the best of English medium schools, and modern science lab, laboratory of science, computer labs, and different levels. The teachers are appointed at a different level according to their skill in the different levels. Due to this level, this school is going day by day in the progress.
Education sector is becoming competitive and challenging day by day. But what are the coming vision and mission of Aishwarya Vidyaniketan in further time?
Yeah, thank you, question. Sorry, question. In Aishwarya Vidyaniketan, in our school, many people want to admit in the Aishwarya Vidyaniketan, but all are not chanced to that school because of there is some problems. The problem is that there is the shortage of infrastructure is well, but the increasing number of students increasing with rapidly, right? But infrastructure is developed slowly. There is a big gap
if we manage, if you develop the different types of modern types of building, we are going to make the building and other others library and provide the different textbook and the reference books, and provide the different means of transportation, just buses and etc. The main vision is as soon as possible, main vision is to build the building and providing the new technical subject, which importance is the society, and we will build this building. That is the mission and vision.
Really, sir. Now, social problems are increasing day by day in our society, like crime, theft, or we can say loss of morality in the sense of our society, isn't it? But what should be done to eradicate such problems from our society? How do you analyze the education system, and what should be done for those removal?
Yeah, for controlling these things, first of all, every people knows the education. Because in our society, most of the people are uneducated. They didn't get the education, lack of the education. If we provide the education to every people, then they know the value of education. If they know the value of education, there is this automatically change. One thing. Now, next thing is that we have to change the society. We have to change the society. There is the happening different crimes, right? There is happening the crimes. For controlling that, we have to counseling, motivation, and due to the government sector to provide the different types of seminar and seminar guestes, and they will change automatically. But I think there is the problem is lack of the education. Nobody can getting the education. If we provide the education, every people. Education is important to all, but there is the only slogan, but nobody getting the education. First of all, we provide the education, they are educated. Such type of crimes automatically change.
But can we say there is weaknesses in our education system, although in cities areas?
Thank you, sir. There is the main problem is the education policy is not good. Due to this kind of education policy, it creates only the unemployment people, right? This education is only the theoretical part, theoretical education. For example, if you read the story of the Jang Bahadur, Bhimsen Thapa, if we study these people, the story, then you will get the job, you will get change your life. No, this education is only theory. If we change the education policy by the government and technical education, if we get the education in our society, the people get the opportunities. But this system of education only the increase the unemployment. So change the education policy. The education policy is not good in our countries.
Yes, sir, we are at the end of our program, sir. What suggestion would you like to give to our audience who are the stakeholder of education, directly or indirectly?
My suggestion is that to the students and the guardians and as well as to the stakeholders, I have to say that first of all, they have to know the education. Education is the important tool. I always saying my students, education is the best of life. So that students has to spend more and more time for their study, and the guardians also visit the schools, and stakeholders to know the education, right? They have to visit the school, and what is the change? What is the change in the school, and what is the problem? What are the problem in the school? If stakeholders visit the schools, and guardians visit the school, if students they are busy in their studying, automatically the change in their lives. Or in this time, most of the students are going the wrong way. They are going wrong way. They don't know the education because of careless of their parents. The parents didn't care their children. Okay, so one of the example, the students say that their parents mommy, daddy, I'm going to take a coaching class with the teachers, right? Due to the coaching classes, he or she spent more than 3 and 4 hours, but the guardian did not care. Why? This is the careless of the guardians. So I'm telling them, please, guardians, you have to care your children, right? You are the candle. You are the parents, right? You are the guider. If you watch the activity to children, then your children, your son and daughter will be changed. Then you will get the change in your children. Please, too busy to check their activities, whether they have done or not, whether they have done well or not, right? And if they have gone outside of the track, they have to visit the school, they have to suggest the principal, they have to suggest to the teachers. But due to the careless, day by day students are going wrong way. Their bad activities are growing, increasing day by day. So they have to solve due to the careless, due to the instruction, due to the help the parents to the children, then automatically the problem will be solved.
Guardian must be conscious regarding their
situation. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much for your valuable time. I'm wishing you all the best for your upcoming time, sir.
Thank you, sir. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Ram, sir, and your teams. You should give me the chance to sharing my feeling, sharing my views in mass of our society. Thank you so much. Keep it up, sir.
Today, we had with us one of the great scholars, having prominent and dazzling personality, the campus chief of Aishwarya Multiple Campus and principal of Aishwarya Vidyaniketan, Mr. Dharmadev Bhatia. Thank you everyone for watching our program. And thank you very much to Anil and Ashok for their technical support. I would like to give a special thanks to our sponsor, Aishwarya Vidyaniketan and GB Mobile Point Dhanbad. So don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to our Apical TV YouTube channel. Thank you. Stay with us.